Good afternoon, everyone. We're so thrilled you're here to join us today. Would you please join us in standing for the National Anthem and the Pledge of Allegiance?
Thank you, and please be seated. To the most amazing band of the land, our Winton Woods High School Marching Band. And welcome to the grand opening of our Winton Woods North Cabins. We're very excited to have everyone here today. We would like to recognize some special guests in the audience, if you could stand after I call your name. Ohio House of Representatives, the Honorable Jessica Miranda. State Board of Education, District 4, the Honorable Jenny Kilgore. Board of Hamilton County Commissioner, the Honorable Alicia Reese. Ohio's Facilities Construction Commissioner, Cheryl Lindman and Ryan Meads. Mayor of Forest Park, the Honorable Charles Johnson. The first Mayor of Forest Park, the Honorable Denise Holt. Second Mayor, Vice Mayor of Forest Park, the Honorable Rosalind Moore. City of Forest Park Council Members, Aaron Brown, Diana Herbie, Chelsea Nuss, and Regina Sylvester. City of Forest Park City Manager, Mr. Donnie Jones. City of Forest Park Chief Alfie Jones II. City of Forest Park Fire Department, Assistant Chief Jermaine Hill. City of Forest Park Police Department, Officer Veda Harris. City of Forest Park Police Department, Officer Rebecca Davis. City of Forest Park Community Development, Chris Anderson. City of Forest Park Recreation Development, Dave Busking. City of Forest Park Buildings Department, Paul Brim. City of Forest Park Chamber of Commerce, Nancy Goins. Mayor of Village of Green Hills, the Honorable Dave Moore. Village of Green Hills Council members, Melanie Hermes, Jack Lee, Natasha Metz, and Martha Walther Willard. Village of Green Hills Municipal Manager, Yvonne Kovac. Village of Green Hills Police Department, Chief Neil Fertelman and Lieutenant Ann Ward. Springfield Township Community Director, Kim Flam. And finally, our former Winton Woods Board of Education members, Kim Burns, John Pennycuff, Jack Lee, Priscilla Franklin, Dr. Brandon Weirs, and Paula Kuhn. Thank you again for coming today. We are so excited to be here, and I'd like to introduce our Student Council President, Emma Smith.
My name is Emma Smith. I'm a senior at Winton Woods High School. I'm the Student Council President. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You guys may now be seated. And I would like to bring up middle school principal, Mr. Doug Sanker. Doug Sanker.
Welcome, everyone. This new schoolhouse represents the commitment of a community, a commitment to the children within its walls. This commitment is generous, future-focused, and is an affirmation for generations to come. Great things can be accomplished together, from the ballot box to the casting of the vision, to the design sessions with students, parents, teachers, and community members, to the leadership of our superintendent, Mr. Smith, the architects, technicians, and workers. Great things are accomplished together. We have a motto at the middle school that we repeat daily, and it applies to today. We are stronger together. We are warriors. It is also my honor to introduce our Winton Woods High School principal, Mr. Eric Martin.
Bear with me a second. I'm undoing myself with my three masks and my earpiece because we're still in school. Dismissal's happening now, so they're talking to me. So please excuse me. Whose idea was this, Steve? Oh, okay. Good afternoon. There, you walk from the front of this building to the back of this building in this unbelievable arena, and that's all the energy I can get when I say good afternoon. Good afternoon. All right. Let's do something real special right now, because it's been a long time for me. I haven't had as many kids as I had in the building today in a very long time, so I got excited about the band. I didn't want to sit down. So can we give our kids a round of applause? Cool. That's awesome. When Mr. Smith instructed me that I would say a few words today, it put me in a place to where I had to reflect on what it means to be standing here right now. I remember about 8 or 9 years ago, there was meetings happening, there was conversations happening, but when you think about it, the building that we're sitting in right now was only a dream. It was only a dream. There were many people who wanted it to happen, but there was also many people that we needed to convince that it was worth it. What you're looking at back there is worth it. It's worth it. It's worth it. The young people that we serve in every building in our district is worth it. The young people that walks the streets to play basketball over across the street in the court, the young people that visits all the stores, the young people that just walk up and down the three communities that we serve, this building, North Campus, South Campus, is worth it. It's worth it. So for me, reflecting on my own personal process, I thought about the dream, I thought about the vision, I thought about the 3,000 planning meetings once we convinced the community that it was a worthwhile venture, a worthwhile venture to ensure that we have an unbelievable learning place for our young people for the next 50 years. Y'all ain't hear me. An unbelievable learning space for the kids we serve in this community for the next 50 years. Gives me goosebumps. One of the things that I was charged with as the high school principal was to make sure that we reimagine teaching and learning in Winton Woods High School. What that meant to me, we had to identify a learning platform and process that will engage our kids, make sure that we were creating leaders, give them the tools to run this country. Now, believe it or not, we made that happen in that building that's a couple of feet away, right? But the beautiful thing about where we're standing today, we have a building that matches our instructional platform. We are a project-based learning district. We have the facility to match. We're probably the only district that can claim in the state of Ohio that our building was designed to amplify how we teach kids on a daily basis. This community has done something special. Please take pride in this. Stand boldly, stick your chest out, because this ride is going to be amazing. So I appreciate the opportunity to lead Winton Woods into its next chapter of teaching and learning at the high school, and thank you so much. And I have the great pleasure of bringing Mr. Steve Denny to the microphone.
Good afternoon, everybody, and Mr. Martin, thank you so much for those wonderful words and for the introduction as well. And I could not be more thrilled today to be here with all of you. And thank you so much for coming out today. It's a beautiful day. It's a brand new day. And we're just excited. So I get an opportunity to share some firsts with you. This is a special building, as you have heard a little bit from Mr. Martin. It is specifically designed around what education needs to look like in the 21st century. The way we came up and the way we learned, we have to admit, the world has drastically... Is that better? Well, that feels pretty good. Thank you. The world's a different place now, isn't it? In so many ways. But it's certainly different than when we were coming up. The world in which we grew up and we were educated in is vastly different than the world in which we're living now. This building is built and designed to serve that, to serve a new type of education. And for the next 50 years, as Mr. Martin mentioned. So here's a little bit of the building pedigree I'll share with you. And we've checked these out. We believe them to be accurate. This is the first building in the state of Ohio to be designed under Ohio's new high performance learning environment standard, or what they call the HPLE standard. All buildings in the state of Ohio were designed under a different standard, and still are, with the OFCC, the Ohio Facility Construction Commission. We're also the first school in the nation to be designed as part of a pre-K-12 building project designed specifically for the New Tech Network style of project-based learning pedagogy. The only school in the nation to be designed as a part of that. According to the New Tech Network, of which we are a proud member, this is the first 712 school in Ohio to be designed specifically for the New Tech Network's project-based learning methodology. This building is trending toward being certified and rated LEED Gold. LEED is an environmental and engineering standard, basically about energy efficiency and environmental friendliness, or green design. So we're trending gold, which is a very high rating in that category. And finally, we've designed our building to as many of the WELL building standards as we could. And we look forward to implementing more of those, because that's all about occupant health and safety and comfort, making this the best place to learn and work that we possibly can, so that we can help our students and staff attain maximum positive results. But all of this did not happen in a vacuum. It happened because there's been a dedicated team of people, many, many people, many of the stakeholders in this room have been a part of the design process, 131 meetings, so thank you for that. Countless construction meetings, site visits to certify the site as safe and to building code and fire code as we look at our city partners and those that helped us attain those goals. And so it's my pleasure to recognize the construction management team and the design firm and the commissioning firm that have really helped bring us to where we are today. We would not be here without you. So I'd like to recognize first from the Ohio Facility Construction Commission, Executive Director Cheryl Lyman. And from the OFCC as well, our project manager, Ryan Meads. Thank you so much, Ryan. With our design firm, our partners, SHP, Allison McKenzie. Jerry Durr, our project manager for construction. And one of the lead design architects and alumni, Forest Park alumni, Mr. Jeff Parker. With Skanska, we're very pleased with their partnership and the relationship we've developed with them and their work. Recognize Don Bensick, site superintendent, here at the 712. I'd also like to recognize Mr. Danny Mitchell, site superintendent, representing Skanska today. And I saw Pete Becker and Chris Hopper sneak in, so just want to give a shout out to those two gentlemen. Thank you so much. With Megan Construction, right here in the city of Forest Park, we're thrilled to be joined today by Evans Nwankwo and his wife, Kathy Nwankwo. And also joining us, a big part of our team here at the 712, project manager here, Jeff Williams with Megan Construction. Jeff. And finally, our commissioning agents, the Moats Engineering Corporation. We're thrilled that they're here today. Joining us is President Susie Murdoch. And also our project coordinator, Kyle Ansbach. So this has been 10 years in the making. We're all thrilled to be here today. Thank you so much for joining us. It's now my honor to introduce the Winton Woods Board of Education President, Ms. Katrina Ruggles.
Good afternoon, Warrior Nation. Today is a great day. Wouldn't you agree?
Today is a great day. I want to invite you to take a trip with me down memory lane to understand why today is so important. Not only because of the ribbon cutting ceremony and the new buildings, but because of the journey that Winton Woods City Schools has been on. Before I became the president of the Board of Education, I was an active parent, and I remain active after my daughter graduated. During this time, I remember hearing different people say that Winton Woods was once a great school district. It made me wonder what was different then that could not happen today. I remember speaking with Mr. Denny at various points of highs and lows, generally around the release of the report card, and sharing with him that I remained encouraged about the future of Winton Woods City Schools. I also remember having a conversation with Mr. Smith shortly after he came, and he'd asked me on multiple occasions, I think he thought my story would change, he'd say, "Ms. Ruggles, what makes you stay involved?" I think he wanted to know the answer because he wanted to figure out how to get rid of me. I told him I was not any different than any other person, any other parent, community member who remained involved. But for me, there were four things that kept me engaged. And like Mr. Martin mentioned, I had a dream. I'm not Martin Luther King, but I had a dream of a time when stakeholders would come together to support students around our shared value for education. I also had hope. I had hope because I saw a community that had not given up on the district. Now, the third and the fourth are guided by my faith in Scripture. Mr. Smith, wherever you are, don't laugh. You see, he always tells me I'm always trying to back up my bad ideas with Scripture. So the third is, for me, is accountability. Luke 12:48 reads in part, "To whom much is given, much is required." We are a blessed community. And for me, I felt as if I had to give back in service. And the last one, which is the fourth, was my favorite, which is a vision. Proverbs 29:18 reads in part, "Where there is no vision, the people perish." What we had was a vision of the past, and we also had an understanding of our current context and where we needed to go. But what we needed was a clear vision and a path for the future forward for the district. That was about 2008 through mid-2013. Now I'm going to talk about our superintendent briefly. So Mr. Smith, hold on tight. You only gave me 5 minutes, so I won't be before you long. You see, Mr. Smith was the path clearer for that plan that we needed, that vision that we needed. Shortly after he became the superintendent in late 2013, I learned that he too held some of those same values that I held. I got excited because I began to see a vision for the district unfold and take shape as he began to convene staff in the community around a shared vision of making Winton Woods City School a destination district with academics as a primary goal. He challenged mindsets, not just around getting support for the new buildings, but he challenged everyone's beliefs on whether or not we believe that all children could achieve at their highest potential. You see, he never lost sight of our shared vision that we built together. And trust me, he was not going to let you lose sight of it either. This was exciting for those of us who understood that Winton Woods City School District was always and still is a treasure in our community. It was just waiting for a vision and a path of excellence to be attached to it. That path of excellence, to excellence, would call for a culture shift that demanded higher expectations, more parent and community engagement, challenged the status quo, and by the way, it also got us new facilities for our children to learn and grow. That deserves a round of applause. While we contributed to the vision, it was Mr. Smith's leadership that got us to where we are today. So I say thank you to you, Mr. Smith, for not only your commitment to our shared vision, but to your covenant to seeing it through. Let's give him and the entire Winton Woods City School District a round of applause. So today, I stand before you in appreciation of the work that went into making this day possible. And I stand proud of the Warrior Nation because this ribbon-cutting ceremony represents a journey of excellence, a journey of unity, value for all stakeholders, no matter where they stand on issues, and the strength of our community. These new buildings are representations of a new mindset and a culture shift in how we see ourselves as a district and community and what we can accomplish together. So in closing, I leave you with the words of our former president, President Barack Obama. He said, "We are what we've been waiting for." And that is, together, we have the power to bring our shared vision forward. He'd also say, "Sí se puede," yes, we can. And I'm here to tell you, not only can we, but we did. And yes, we will continue to move the Winton Woods City School District forward, collectively achieving through our connected hands. That said, I say to the Warrior Nation, stay tuned in. Stay connected, not only for this ribbon-cutting ceremony, but because we need you to continue on this journey with us, a journey of progress. Thank you. Now I'd like to introduce the Winton Woods City School District Board of Education Vice President, Dr. Viola Johnson.
Hello, good evening, welcome. What a wonderful occasion it is that we're here for tonight. And thank you for taking the time out of your day to attend the Winton Woods North Campus grand opening. I am Dr. Viola Johnson, and I currently serve as the Vice President of the Winton Woods City School Board of Education. It is my pleasure to stand here before you, and I don't take it for granted that I'm in the position to do this, to extend a very heartfelt thank you to the building design team, SHP, Skanska, Megan, Superintendent Smith, Treasurer Seymour, Executive Director of Business Affairs, Mr. Steve Denning, all of our stakeholders, our volunteers, our teachers, our administrators, as well as our wonderful community partners, for the dedication and sacrifice in making the dream in a reality becoming true up to our district to have these new buildings. This awesome occasion of the Winton Woods North grand opening has created a climate of heightened accountability, limited resources, and effective leadership that continues to be critical as we're standing in this beautiful edifice. For many, working to pass the bond levy for the new buildings was a labor of love. We had a lot of people who came together who pushed and pushed and pushed, and it wasn't always easy. But it was a labor of love for our school district, and we were facing real challenges with some very old buildings that needed enormous repairs. So our stakeholders, our community partners, our parents, our students, teachers, administrators, and mentors all came together and met the challenges that revealed unique opportunities to rally support in this new educational facility. The building has been designed, as Mr. Martin had already said, they've been designed one of the only type of buildings that has been designed with our education, our academics in mind. So it's built thinking forward to the future of high academic standards for the students of the Winton Woods City School District. As we enter into the next phase of our journey, and this is not the end, This is just a phase. As we enter into the next phase of our journey, we continue to welcome your continued support to work with the district, either as a mentor or a volunteer, as you encounter the things that we will encounter moving forward. Again, thank you for your overwhelming support. We appreciate all that you have done to make this happen for us. And now I'd like to introduce Mr. Jeff Birdie, who is the member of the Winton Woods City School Board member.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson. As someone who's actually lived in this district for over 57 years now, I went to high school in the building that's over there. I have two sons that graduated from this school district. I currently have a grandson that's going to school in this district, and I have another one within a couple of years that will be in this district. I am incredibly proud that we're here today to celebrate what's happening here today. If you had asked me in March of last year, would we have an opportunity to have this today with what was going on in the world, the pandemic, the way it was impacting us locally, nationally, and the entire world, I would have said there isn't a chance that we're going to be able to open this building this year. So I want to specifically thank Mr. Smith, Mr. Seymour for their leadership in getting us to where we are, and especially Mr. Denny here. I think he invited me to like 400 meetings, many of which I wasn't able to attend, but I know he was at every one of them. So thank you, and to your family for allowing you to do what you did. I hope you have a really nice vacation scheduled once this is all said and done. Thank you to Skanska Megan, for their leadership, SHP, OFCC. I mean, none of this happens without all of you doing what you could do to get us here, so thank you all for that. And, you know, lastly, this is really for the students and for the families that live here in this district now, and as Mr. Martin said, for generations to come. This is going to facilitate the learning process for our students and move us to new places and give them opportunities that many of us, you know, may not have had when we were in school. So awfully proud of what's happening here today, and, you know, thank you to everybody. As a grandparent, I did have the opportunity to sit with my grandson during remote learning. Teachers, utmost respect for what you're trying to do. When you're doing remote learning with 6 and 7 year olds, it's an incredibly difficult process. So thank you for your efforts. Thank you to all the staff, transportation, food service, anybody and everybody involved in what's going on here, parents, students. It's been phenomenal. So thank you very much.
I have Dr. John Cupoletti on the phone. He is a board member, and he'd like to have some remarks. So let me see if I can get this to work. Mr. Cupoletti? Dr. Cupoletti?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, you're on.
So I would like to thank all of you who are present now and the entire district for supporting the building projects. They will serve our community for generations to come. I'm pleased to have been a part of this.
Thank you, Dr. Cupoletti.
Thank you.
And now we'll have Emma Smith, of Student Council President, in to introduce our next speaker.
I would just like to thank everybody for coming again tonight. I now want to introduce the Winton Woods Superintendent, Mr. Anthony G. Smith, for his overview of the district.
Okay, you just heard from my daughter, Emma Smith. Before I give you a brief review, I'd like to say a special thanks to my good friend, Vice President of Hamilton County Board of Commissions, Ms. Alicia Reese. Thank you very much for coming. So how many of you have been in a situation where you've heard the same thing five or six times? Anybody ever heard that before, been part of it? Well, I'd like to introduce some people, and these were board presidents, former board presidents, Mr. John Pennycuff, Mr. P. Ms. Kim Burns. State Rep. Jessica Miranda. Dr. Viola Johnson. And Ms. Katrina Ruggins. So these are the people, the presidents of the board, these are the people that kind of tell me what to do. All right, so I had to introduce them again. And one of the things they said when we were working on my goals, they said, Superintendent, some of the things that you come up with make sense, but others are challenging. And we'd like to tell you that one of the things we need you to do is to have more people come to the state of the schools. And that was always a goal, always a challenge. And then my good friend, Ms. Burns, said, not only do we want you to do that, we want you to have two state of the schools, all right? So I could never meet the challenge for having more than 100 people at the state of the schools. So this really nice Filipino lady, she's about this tall, all right? Where is she? She might be standing up, so you might miss her anyway. But she came to me and she said, I have a plan. We always have a plan. We meet every morning. And she says, I can help you meet your goal of having over 100 people at the state of the schools. I was like, whoa, how do we do that? She says, make your state of the schools the ribbon cutting ceremony. So you're here. So thank you very much. This is state of the schools. And so here, and this will go quickly. So to President Katrina Ruggles, you never got the opportunity to tell me to bring more people because now I'm here. So thank you. So what do these buildings mean to our students? It means a lot. It means a lot. Where Principal Martin talked about the excitement of being able to come into a building where you feel appreciated, you feel loved, you feel cared for. And it wasn't that the custodial team was neglecting the old buildings. Things just get old. And when things get old, they need to be upgraded or replaced. We found out the price of upgrading a building was almost as much as building new. And we gave the architects, incredible engineers, incredible construction people, Skanska, as well as SHP, we gave them the challenge, we don't want to move our kids while we're building a new building. Because if you've ever been in a situation with swing space, you lose half of your children, and they never come back. And when you look out and you see the old buildings, some of them, it's like 50 feet away from the new space. That was incredible. They need a round of applause for that. What does it mean to our parents? You have pride in bringing your children to a place that you can appreciate. You can have great meetings, you can have conferences, you can have PTA opportunities, and your children and you feel respected walking through the door. So to every parent who sends your child to Winton Woods City Schools, thank you very much. This is a district of destination. This is a place where your child can be properly educated. And to you, Miss Miranda, thank you for leaving the girls here. I appreciate you very much. I check on them regularly to make sure they're still here. And guess what? They are. So thank you again. What does it mean to our community? This place is not just based on school and academics. It's based on how the community at large can use this arena to learn and grow with our students, to teach them, to work with them, to be their entrepreneurs, to be their architects, to help them through this process called life. Our children have gone through an amazing, amazing thing, and not one adult in this building right now who has a high school education can say, I had that experience of COVID-19, because you did not. Our children have endured. They have gone through a very, very rough time. So we got really crazy, and we said, hey, let's open the new building and bring all the kids back the same day. And when I looked outside and my car tires weren't flying, I knew that it was a good plan. So we brought the kids back today, and we're opening a brand new building today in the middle of COVID. Because guess what? We're determined people, and as you see at the sign all around, we are warriors. That's who we are, and that's what we do. Some people made reference to the strategic plan. How do we look at it? One of the major pieces of the strategic plan was to make sure that we were respecting everybody in our community. The Native American warrior that you saw proudly displayed in so many different parts of the arena, we found out to the Native American people, they're not proud that we have that on our shields and on our emblems and on our floors. So we made a decision years ago that we were going to start moving that off of our platform and just use our two major symbols, the warrior symbol with the spear, and also the WW, which denotes books and education. Now, you might see the best band in the land behind me, and you're like, wait a minute, Superintendent, they still have that logo on their uniforms. But that's where you come in. You're going to help me raise money to get new ones, so thank you very much. Appreciate you. All right? Okay. Can I get some love for that one right there? Okay, all right. PBL, you heard Mr. Martin mention it. Project-based learning was never intended, let me tell you again, it was never intended for children of color or children that have socioeconomic challenges. It was never designed for them. Because project-based learning kids are kids who are leaders. It was never designed for our kids to be leaders. We intercepted that dream. And now our kids are part of the leading process. And I'm going to read something. Why we do it. It's important to understand the impact of PBL on the academic achievement of students from low-income backgrounds because practices common to PBL, which give students more autonomy over their learning than typical instruction affords them, are less frequently used in high-poverty schools as compared with those with students from higher-income communities. Never designed for children of socioeconomic challenges. But we broke through. The other part. The findings of this study indicate that this issue deserves the attention of system leaders and policymakers, as there is strong evidence that all students can benefit from engaging in sense-making through project-based learning. This entire event, this entire arena, this entire district, this entire school is a project-based learning experience. It took a lot of hands and a lot of effort to make it happen, a lot of conversations. So how many of you have had the pleasure of attending our Night of Freedom? Okay. Incredible event, but guess what? The Night of Freedom will be here. We're not going to travel into the city. We have two beautiful campuses, and we're going to have the Night of Freedom right here in our own backyard so that everybody can get a chance to come. The The Night of Freedom this year, I will be singing two great songs that I wrote. So come early because the songs are short. They only last like maybe 20 seconds. As you came in, you received a mask. And a mask is very symbolic of who we are, what we do, what we stand for in our pride. And it says, love our children, love our schools, love our community. This is about love. And in order for us to get this right, the love has to be passed on from generation to generation. Love built this school. Love built this school. And the way our kids get immersed into love is by loving each other. And I can tell you, based on the socialization of life, many of our kids are struggling because they have not been with their peers for over a year. I have preschoolers that have never met their teacher. Ninth graders who've never been in the building before. And so we needed to come back in order to express it in the way that we needed to, make sure that people understand that love brought us here today and love will keep us here. What does the participation in the East Central League mean to us? When I came here as a superintendent, we were not in a league. Now we are. Not only were we in the league this year, first introduced, but we were also the league champs in football. Now, the ECC does not have a topic or a process connected to it as who is the superintendent of the year, but I voted for myself. So I was the superintendent of the year for the ECC, all right? And I hope to get that same opportunity next year, okay? Mr. Martin, do I have your vote, sir? All right. Mr. Snyder, back there from the Oaks, do I have your vote, sir? All right, okay, thank you. So I am going to be the ECC Superintendent of the Year next year. Finally, as we talk about education, the main piece about getting kids to be educated properly is to get them here safely. We have been fighting a good fight. We are now ready to launch that with integrity and respect. So the high school students' busing will be restored for this year. And where's Mr. Gray? Mr. Gray, stand up. He is our transportation director. I was very impressed when I met Mr. Gray because I felt like I was on a male Oprah show. He was like, you get a bus, you get a bus, and you get a bus. So Mr. Gray, thank you very much. Restoring busing to our high schoolers is very, very important. It will get them here on time and they will be properly engaged. 87% of my staff received COVID shots, the vaccine. And I am very, very pleased that they were able to do it. So my great friend, I love him dearly. He is my doctor. And I went to visit him for a routine checkup. And he told me he had received the vaccine. He looked healthy, he looked happy. So I figured I may try it as well. Dr. Wilson, thank you very much. You convinced me to do it. He seemed happy and smiling, so I figured there must be something in the vaccine that makes you happy. Next piece. Our children have not been in school for a year, almost a year. So the teaching and learning department, we've come up with something very amazing. One of the things that stopped us from having a year-round experience is because our buildings were not properly air-conditioned. Well, we don't have that excuse anymore. We're going to put on the most robust special summer school program that you have ever heard of. It will be for enriching children. It will be for gifted children. It will be for children who struggle, children who want to get better, parents who want to send their children to have experience that they've never had before. And it will be right here. So one of the things that we want to discuss later on down the road is the chances of us becoming a year-round school. Folks, we need to make up for lost time. And there's only one way to do it, by putting more time and work into the program. You can clap. Where is my great friend, Mr. Mark Doctor? Stand up, Mr. Doctor. This guy is absolutely amazing. Over 827 meals served since COVID. You need to give him some love for that. Okay, you saw straight ahead Mr. Doctor's team. I know you thought that they were models, but they're not only models, they're also food service workers. Stand up, please. Some of you heard about, wait a minute, something's wrong here in the land of school. There will not be a cafeteria. There will be food. There will not be a cafeteria. If you were building a new house, Mr. Brim, and you told the people you wanted your living room to be 50 by 50, they could do that, but other rooms would have to be smaller, correct, sir? So we made a sacrifice. Our students told us during the visioning process, they don't even like large cafeterias. They like more intimate dining. So we put in what's called distributed dining, where the food comes to them. And when you're on tour, you'll see various locations where students can have food and not have these large groups. They can work on projects together, have collective conversations together. When Mr. Denny and I were first putting this together, people were looking at us like, whoa, this is a problem. Now with COVID, you really don't want all of those people together. So guess what? Thank you, sir. We were smart on that one. Thank you very much. So some of the people who have been here before said, Superintendent, I'd like to give some love back to my old place. So we're going to actually have tours. We're going to send that information out to you. The tours are listed. We're going to make sure that they're posted everywhere, Mrs. Denny, where you know how you can come and visit the old school, the high school, and also the old middle school. We want to give you a chance to have your nostalgic moments and take pictures of where you met that first girl by the cafeteria door and how you got rejected the next day. So we want you to have all those experiences and love it. And know that we want you to know that we are connecting this school with that school. In our hallways, one of the things you will notice, we will have signage all the way through. There will be signs of the old schools listed with plaques letting us know that our past and our future are connected together. We need volunteers, as Dr. Johnson mentioned, for a variety of things. Not just about tutoring, but just about loving kids and treating them good and talking about your experiences and bringing those experiences to life. So one of the things that you will see, it is actually going to be in the South Campus to start. And I know people didn't quite understand, well, why is it in the South Campus? It starts in the South Campus. If we're going to have vision, dental, and hearing screening, we want it to be for the little guys first. And so that community learning center will be where the little kids are. Now I know people say, well, what about what happens on the North Campus of where we are? When we renovate the intermediate building that will be the preschool village, it is our goal that we will have a community learning center, one in Forest Park and also in Green Hills. So both communities will be served very, very appropriately. And this community learning center, I don't want people to be mistaken about it. This is not just for children. This is for adults in the community. So right now, most of the adults that are over 60 receive their first vaccine, or maybe even their second. Well, we want the community learning centers to be more than just where you receive vaccines. We want the community learning centers to be a place where you can get taken care of. So, Dr. Wilson, thank you again for your vision. And Justin, thank you from Mercy for giving us great ideas about how the CLC can work collectively together. We appreciate you guys very much. Rhonda Hobbs, thank you. And the next slide is really depicting about not if the next pandemic, but when. We have to be prepared. And I have to tell you, the tech department served in an incredible way where they were able to deploy technology for all the kids so that we can keep the learning moving. And that took a lot of work and a lot of manpower. Thank you very, very much. When Mr. Martin mentioned that our graduates are supposed to be prepared to be the next generation, the next leaders of this community, he really means that. And I'd like to know, I don't know if she's here, is Ms. Van Dyke here? Is Hannah here? Hannah was one of our first students to go through project-based learning. She's a graduate, and guess what? She's one of our teachers, one of our math teachers right here at Winton Woods City Schools. That's the kind of work we're talking about. And Mr. Brim, you will be happy, Mayor Johnson. Our leaders, our young leaders, are poised in a position to be the next generation of economic developers in this community. They want to give back to the community and be part of it, and that's what good communities do. So, August 10th, August 31st is open house. We get to do this all over again. Already have my next suit lined up. I know what I'm going to wear. So we will be absolutely prepared for a ribbon-cutting ceremony in the South Campus. Here's the thing that you all came to hear, more than anything else. What about May 4th? May 4th is the levy. We need your support. We need that levy to pass, so that we keep all programs moving for every child in this district. I want everyone to raise their hand if you have the same budget from 2009 that you have now, the same budget in your household. The last time we passed a levy, an operating levy, folks, was 2009. Most districts are every 3 to 4 years. And I have my good friend in the back, Mr. Snyder, over the fabulous Great Oaks program. Is that accurate, Mr. Snyder? Every 3 to 4 years. We haven't been here for 12 years. That's unheard of. Mr. Seymour, where is Mr. Seymour? Mr. Seymour, thank you for keeping the dollars right and making the budgets work. You have been a magician in many, many ways. And now we have to make sure that we have the magic to celebrate your victory by making sure that we can take care of the business like we need to without you juggling so many dollars in so many different ways. So thank you, Mr. Seymour, for all of your work. So, where is Mrs. Jordan again? Mrs. Jordan usually has a sign. If you ever came to my first State of the Schools, it was 4 hours and 52 minutes, okay? And people didn't love me like that. They were like, why is this taking so long? I said, I had a lot to say. We're excited now that you get a chance to participate in the ribbon-cutting ceremony of what you came for. Thank you very much for sneaking into my State of the Schools. You were invited. You will be invited back again. And to the former board presidents, thank you very much. I reached my goal. There are more than 100 people here. Oh, here she is. I know you, come up closer. I know you guys thought this was Connie Chung. This is not Connie, all right? This is Jeanette Jordan. She is an incredible, incredible lady. She works hard for an insane person. And she made a lot of this happen along with Karina Denny, communications director in the back. Stand up, Mrs. Denny. My teaching and learning compadres, Dr. Raglan and Dr. Martin, stand please. My human resource director and our attorney who keeps me out of trouble, Ms. Courtney Wilson, stand please. We have a host of people that just love kids. And wear your mask proudly because we want this to be about loving children. We want to see you out May 4th celebrating with us another victory, passing the levy. And I know that collectively we can do it because we have the right people on the bus. So thank you. And Ms. Jordan, take over.
Thank you, Mr. Smith. At this time, we will commence our ribbon cutting ceremony, and we will begin with the first flight of ribbon cutters. Flight one, if you would please rise and obtain your scissors and go to the front where the ribbon will be ready for you. And I will be giving the signal when it is time to cut the ribbon. All right, at this time, go ahead and please make your cuts to cut the ribbon in front of you. Flight two, if you would please rise and please process towards the scissor table and obtain your scissors. All right, we're waiting on everyone to get in position. Yes?
Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be.
Okay, everyone, please make your cut. Flight two. And you may also obtain your commemorative box for your scissors, and feel free to take your ribbon as a souvenir. All right, looks like everyone's in position. Please make your cut, ribbon cutters. Thank you, and if you please make your way to the table where the boxes are for your commemorative box. All right, if you're ready, oh, I guess we're not ready yet, it's okay. Okay, at this time, please go ahead and make your cut. Flight four. Thank you. And then you may obtain your commemorative box as well, if you'd make your way to the box table, please. And last but not least, flight five. All right, if you would please go ahead and make your cuts, please, flight five. Wonderful, thank you. That concludes our ribbon cutting ceremony. Thank you for all those who've attended. And at this time, feel free to walk around at our new North Campus.
So we get in there, and you can just see how worried he is about getting his So.
So these are stationary because they have gas in them.
Yeah.
But you got your
force
there.
You can actually see the gas and air labels now.
That was scary.
We kind of wanted the whole building to feel like a collegiate experience.
Yeah, actually, we went to the music room on like the space and all. It feels very official and like professional.
We'll try. Thank you.
Yes, sir. I say, I don't know.